So this is just as relevant from B2B as B2C, and I can tell you because it's the same model that we use to great success, is you actually want to kind of think about the system from who are the fans and natural people who love your brand? Or if it's more technical, whether it's technical advice or it's technical because it is tech, who are the people who are your brand or technical champions? Or who evangelize because they've had a wonderful experience? How do you connect them in? Now, they're unlikely to have big following. They can, which is awesome, but then if they do, they might be in this influencer category. Now, influencers, and you might have heard a lot about that, these are people who have already learnt the art of telling great stories and of delivering value, and hence they've built a big community of people who follow them because they believe they're following someone credible, authentic, and like them, and who they want to be in terms of selling that magic and the stories. So influencers might not be technical, but they know how to tell great stories and they know how to get reach. Okay, now if it's an organisation and who's either new or disruptive or innovative or B2B, it's again coming back to this relationship, people are actually looking at the people in organisations. Okay, they don't buy brand or product or services, they buy a belief that you're going to give them this better way. So making sure your senior leadership team is also very congruent in and active and telling the story, because it's what drives them in social as well. And if that's connected in the sense of influencers are connected to senior leadership team, there's a great learning cycle going on there where influencers are actually helping the leadership team understand what's important to the consumer. But they can also help amplify awesome messages. So the actual messages that is about, you know, that leadership of whatever your brand's representing your market. And then of course you've got employees, advisors, partners to your business, that you should also think about how do you engage them into your influence ecosystem. Because they also, if you help enable them, they can be great storytellers for you as well. You do need to think about it from a content and social, engagement and enablement. How can you enable this ecosystem? How can you inspire that ecosystem? How can you invest in a way that actually helps create great stories that you feed through this ecosystem? Because if you get this working really well, you will influence your customers and the decisions that they're making in terms of what they're purchasing. And this influencer marketing, it's not just paid for comment. You want to create an environment that means everyone wins. But it's not like a novelty, it's actually critical, because people don't follow brands as much as they follow people. They're more likely to trust a person, they follow people, and they follow those people who are great storytellers. And then you've got other trends going on, right? So 47% of people are using adblock technology. So you can't expect, like you may have in the early days, to have reached them through any other way anyhow. So, you know, 92% of people trust recommendations from individuals even if they don't know them over brands. So it doesn't matter, even if you've paid to get a customer case study and they have given you a video and it shows them saying it and you've quoted a stat that they've said and put it on your website, and then put in social, that is less credible than someone else just putting it as their own words, natural language, in social.